good afternoon and welcome. My name is Michael Pickett. I am the District 9 Instrumental Chair, and on behalf of the directors here at the 9th District, we'd like to welcome you to the District 9 Honor Band. Before we begin, we want to give out a couple little thank yous. First and foremost, thank you to Dr. Scott Barnstead and Fannin County for the use of this amazing facility. If you want to know who Dr. Scott Barnstead is, he's the guy that's carrying the tuba. And he's fixing a tuba for a kid right now. Just a second ago, he was in the rafters setting up a video. He's done so much, and so it's really awesome how much he has helped to put this thing on. So thank you, Dr. Barnstead. Dr. Barnstead has a student teacher named Matthew Thompson, and Matthew, we want to thank him wherever he's at. He made copies for all the kids, for all the music, for all three bands. As a band director, that's a very daunting task, and he did a fantastic job. So thank you, Matthew, wherever you're at. And then in the back, the conductors chose a couple pieces that call for piano, and we have a nice man who filled in for piano. Mr. George Otwell is in the back playing piano on a couple of the pieces this afternoon. So thank you, Mr. Otwell. If you didn't get a chance to get a program, programs should have been at the entrances on a little white table if you would like to get one of those. Also, some people asked about t-shirts. The t-shirt company was unable to make it today. But hopefully your director will receive a link this week sometime with a link to the t-shirt company. So if you want to order a District 9 Honor Band shirt, you can do so. Also, this concert this afternoon is going to be video filmed. So at this time, two things. Number one, if you don't mind turning off everything that makes noise. And then number two, your director should also receive a link that they can email out to receive a copy of that video. And then in your program, you have this awesome little bio sheet. And if you start reading through it like I like to, you will see that we have three amazing conductors today. And those amazing conductors have done a fantastic job with your children over the last, day and a half, 2 days? And I think you're going to be pleasantly surprised. So without further ado, conducting the Clinic Honor Band is Mr. Scott King.
Good afternoon. Thank you so much for the opportunity to work with these fine musicians. This district has such a wonderful reputation in the state for its band programs, band directors, middle school and high school, and students. So it was a thrill for me to do this. The students have been really respectful and worked really hard. They've been patient with me. So it's been a lot of fun in the process. So we are very proud of what we're gonna present today. So I hope you enjoy it. I know we're gonna have fun performing it. On stage now is the District 9 Clinic Honor Band. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. This next piece that we're going to be playing is called Flight of Passage. I was honored to interview six World War II veterans, each with a fascinating story. All had aged gracefully, some giving accounts of their war service for the 1,000th time, some opening up for the first time. Their individual stories ranged from sobering liberation of Buchenwald concentration camp to the 600-year guilt of being stationed in Greenland away from hostilities, while hometown buddies were fighting and dying on Anzio Beach in Italy. The two women in the group whom I interviewed had amazing stories. One was a naval gunnery instructor, and the other was part of the USO tours. From the European and Pacific theaters to the American home front, these individuals and their World War II experiences were indicative of the common bond of service that characterizes the greatest generation. Their stories were the inspiration for writing The Flights of Passage. Additionally, Flights of Passage was written to commemorate the dedication of the National World War II Memorial in Washington, D.C. in May 2004. This piece is programmatic in nature, with six segments depicting the various passages that all Americans experienced in some way, both overseas and here at home.
Thank you. Thank you. technological developments like the automobile, radio, and sound motion pictures were in their infancy and contributed to the excitement and jubilance of the day. Post-World War I, return to normalcy was more of a call to stay out and party all night, for Americans were people of few cares and great enthusiasms for winkings, carousing, and mirthful sprees. Peter Finley Dunn's Mr. Dooley philosophized about almost anything from behind the bar at his fictitious pub, and people flocked into movie houses to see and hear his The First Talking, the jazz singer, while conservative Republicans retained control of Congress and silent Cal Coolidge occupied the White House, Americans were whooping it up with Daffy Abandon. It was the time of all-night speakeasies and the glistening new Empire State Building, the New York Yankees, Murderers Row, and the Algonquin Roundtable of Bessie Smith and Duke Ellington, of Clara Bow and Jimmy Cagney. Men in raccoon coats and baggy pants escorted women in knee-length dresses with feather boas and cloth hats. Fashion was all-important and fads came as quickly as they went, but no one seemed to care. Life was just too good to have many cares. New York 1927 is a musical snapshot of this colorful and merry time. The opening ragtime depicts the prosperous and carefree spirit of the times. Blues rhapsodizes wistfully and whimsically in Roaring Twenties fashion. Manhattan Mayhem cleverly creates a typical busy street scene at a midtown intersection, perhaps at 5th Avenue and 34th Street, as cars weave in and around, police whistles shriek in attempted jurisdiction, and a barrage of pedestrians scurry onward.
Thank you.
Again, can we thank the Clinic Honor Band and their director, Mr. Scott King from Stars Mill. All right, good afternoon again. AWB is selling t-shirts and memorabilia in the lobby. If you didn't get a chance before the concert, you can go in between or after the concert to pick up that kind of stuff. Also, if you didn't remember or came in after, please silence all electronic devices. We're just waiting for percussion to get their last minute stuff set, and then we'll begin with the concert honor band. Concert honor band with their conductor from Young Harris College, Dr. Hayes Bunch. Thank you.
How's everyone's day going today? Do you guys like the concert so far? Well, my name is Gargi Sarange, and I am a bass clarinet. I am a student at Alliance Academy for Innovation, which is in Forsyth County. So the piece that you just heard was Melodious Thunk. It was by David Beedenbender, and it was inspired by the famous jazz pianist Thelonious Monk. Monk's wife, Nellie Smith, nicknamed him Melodious Thunk because of his clunky, awkward, and brilliant piano playing, and his somewhat scatterbrained and disoriented nature. There were no direct quotes from the music of Monk, although a short fragment from Dizzy Gillespie's tune Salt Peanuts was used. Now for our next piece, we will share Brian Balmage's Elements. Four short movements make up this petite symphony, constructed in the same form as the elements of a traditional symphony: allegro, non troppo, largo, scherzo, and allegro vivace. Each movement also refers to an element of nature. Movement one, air, which is light and breathy, made of mostly staccato notes. Water, the second movement, ripples and flows softly and gently. An homage to Gustav Holst's The Planets can be heard in Earth, the third movement. This piece concludes in an intense inferno with fire. Thank you.
Thank you.
great, wasn't it? Y'all ready for some more? All right, so the next piece is Stephen Bryant's Bloom. Bloom was commissioned by the Northwest North Carolina Bandmasters Association for the All-District Middle School Symphonic Band. The composer offers the following words about the work. It is a celebration of springtime, the bright sunny days with nature in bloom all around. It gives me a powerful sense of well-being, simultaneously tranquil and exuberant. Bloom is my attempt to recreate that feeling. So give it up for Bloom.
Thank you.
here comes one of the band's favorites. So for our next piece, we will share Rob Diemer's Dream Circus. Have you ever dreamt of running away to join the circus? That is exactly what this piece does. Opening with an expansive introduction, the dream state begins only to fade into the excitement of the big top. Snippets of circus themes play as the percussion adds to its unique touch with whistles, whips, and horns heralding the circus towns. Dream Circus was commissioned by the Northern Illinois All University Band. Lawrence Stoffel, conductor. Give it up for Dream Circus.
Thank you.
We will share Dmitri Shostakovich Gallop. Admirers of Shostakovich's symphonies and concertos are likely unaware that the composer also wrote a substantial quantity of lighter music. In his early days, he composed incidental music and songs for many plays, and even created full-fledged operas and film scores. Among them is the operetta Moscow, Cheremushki, which opened on January 24, 1959, to substantial success. Moscow Cheremushki, often shortened to Cheremushki, is an operetta, which is a light opera, in three acts, with a libretto by the team of Vladimir Mass and Mikhail Chervinsky, the leading Soviet humorist at that time. The satirical plot deals with a theme common to the people of Soviet Russia in the Cheremushki district, which is affordable housing. This district became the location for a massive subsidized housing project in the 1950s. The operetta tells a story of a group of friends who have been granted new apartments in the Cheremushki, which each character we see common issues associated with the living in these areas, shared living spaces, corrupt politicians, and sneaky bureaucrats. Gallop is a representative of light, humorous style of the operetta, with its fast-moving and comical lines. Shostakovich captures the human and melancholy of the libretto expertly. So give it up for Gallop.
Thank you, Gardner. Thank you all. I'm Hayes Bunch, and I serve as the director of bands at Young Harris College and assistant professor of music there. And in Young Harris, Georgia, by the way. And I have had the great pleasure of creating live sound with these incredible musicians over the past 2 days and the student musicians behind me for the past 2 days. And thank you all for the opportunity. I really am so thankful to be here, and it's an honor and a privilege. And they have been a joy to lead. And on that note, I want to take a moment, because we owe their fine teachers and directors a round of applause for the thoughtful artist teaching that I know the students are receiving on a daily basis in their own work. I know those folks are doing amazing work, and the endless days and hours they put in, and it's just, the fruits of the labor are right here before you in terms of live sound, and we're so thankful to have all of them. Comprehensive music education matters, and you see before you a collection of individuals who all have a very unique artistic voice to share with the world. And without your support and that of your local school districts and your communities, their voices may be stifled, and we never want that. So spread the word, you know, that music making has a place in the curriculum of these brilliant minds, and wave the banner for arts education in general in your area. I thank you all again. The organizing directors in District 9 for putting this event together. It takes a village. And I thank these fine students for sharing their incredible talents with us all over the past 2 days. And so please enjoy the Shostakovich.
Thank you.
Gentlemen, the last band we have this afternoon is the Honor Symphonic Band with their conductor, Dr. Scott Stewart. Dr. Stewart is the musical director and conductor of the Atlanta Youth Wind Symphony. So please join me in welcoming the Symphonic Honor Band with their conductor, Dr. Scott Stewart.
Thank you. so great to be able to make music and share it with you. We've had about 12 hours of rehearsal, and this concert represents something that probably an advanced college would do after 6 weeks of rehearsal. So super proud of these amazing musicians on the stage. I want to thank all of them for really a terrific set of rehearsals that has been super artistic, and I think we've enjoyed good fellowship as well. Thanks so much to Dr. Scott Barnstead and Michael Pickett for the invitation to be here and to work with really one of the power blocks in the country for music education that kind of goes straight up the middle of the state, and a really wonderful set of colleagues that I'm very proud to know as fellow teachers and friends that teach in this district, a really remarkable set of music educators. And thanks to all of you who are short order cooks and chauffeurs and scheduling directors. The classes that I usually refer to as the lesser academic classes, like English and Spanish and history, those have to be attended to, but we appreciate everything that goes into music education, which is all a lot of sacrifice on your part. I'm convinced more than ever that this is the most important, impactful part of education at any level of development, and it's a joy to be a part of that process. We tried to bring you a little bit of variety today, and we'd like to close with a piece that also connects to the first piece that you heard, the little Ode to Joy quote. And if any of you are John Adams, the composer, fans, you might hear a little bit of Short Ride in a Fast Machine. This is Joyride by Michael Markowski.